In July 1969, exactly 50 years ago today, hey, it's like we planned it that way, the Apollo 11 mission landed on the moon for the first time. But why do we do it? And why haven't we been back since 1972? Space exploration yields untold scientific possibilities, but the science was not the main reason we went to the moon. Okay, so by the way, I'm not going to dabble in whether or not we did actually land people on the moon. Let's just pretend they did for now. Actually, that does fit really well into what this video is about, because the moon landings were done not purely out of altruistic scientific goals, but out of geopolitical competition, which means that there was definitely plenty of controversy here. Anyway, in the 1950s and 60s, the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics and the Union of American Capitalist States were locked in a famous rivalry now known as the Space Race. This was just a part of the Cold War that the US and the USSR found themselves caught in, also known as the Cold War. But reaching the moon was just as geopolitically important as it was scientifically. Why is this? Well, first, some context. After World War II, the US was one of the few participating countries to have not been completely destroyed, having been over 6,000 kilometers from Germany, an imperial that's approximately a crap ton of miles. And so American industry remained virtually unaffected, while this was very much not the case in Europe and Asia. Thus, American manufacturing boomed, and the US suddenly found itself at basically the top of the ladder in a new age of prosperity, which meant that they would also surely now be the first to new scientific accomplishments. Right? But then, the Soviets launched Sputnik 1 in 1957, the first thing to go to space, aside from some Nazi V-2 rockets. Then they launched a dog that died, and then two dogs that lived. Then a man went up, and then a woman. While this was happening, the US also tried to get in on the fun. After all, they should have been first to all this, right? But all they were doing was catching up to the Soviets' achievements. However, it wasn't just jealousy that motivated the US into space. It was also oil. This was the age in which the US had gone from being virtually untouchable, like the entire rest of its history, to suddenly being able to be destroyed in mere hours. The things that made this possible were intercontinental ballistic missiles, or ICBMs. They kind of look like rockets, don't they? Yeah, that's no coincidence. After all, Russia's prominent Vostok rockets were based on designs for its Semyorka rockets, which were ICBMs. So, if either side could use their rockets to launch a payload into space and deorbit them, especially onto a predetermined landing site, what would happen if that payload just so happened to be a nuclear bomb, was the worry of the other side. With this in mind, it became clear to President Kennedy what the US needed to do.
We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Certainly hard goals to achieve by the end of the decade. Oh, and speaking of which, I'm trying to get this channel to 100,000 subscribers by the end of this decade. Not because it is easy, but because it is hard. Anyway, with that new goal in mind, NASA started the Apollo program, with the goal of getting an American astronaut to the moon by the year 1970. And they succeeded, bringing four American astronauts to the moon in 1969, and eight more over the next few years, being the first to do so. Except for the Vikings 500 years earlier. So yeah, it's been exactly 50 years since we first landed on the moon, and about 46 years, 7 months, and 6 days since we last took off from it, with only 12 men having walked on the surface of the moon, which is even smaller than the population of Spain. In the meantime, there have been no manned missions out of low Earth orbit. However, there are also geopolitical reasons for this. In fact, there are geopolitical reasons for what has been going on since, with the establishment of different internationally operated space stations, like the International Space Station, established in partnership between the Americans and the now not communist Russians, and various other countries, all starting with the Apollo Soyuz project, involving the docking of an American Apollo spacecraft and a Russian Soyuz craft. Man, people here are really good at naming things. So, without this sense of competition from the no longer existent USSR, NASA has been kind of put on the back burner in recent decades. Since the fall of the Soviet Union, the US has effectively been the only superpower in the world, though this may soon change, with the rise of potential superpowers, like flight, superspeed, telekinesis, like China, India, the EU, Brazil, and even Russia again. Now, the term superpower is an incredibly vague one that may or may not get its own video at some point, but many say that the US's time in the spotlight is already limited, what with China and India's massive growth over the past few decades. China, India, Europe, and several other countries also have their own thriving space programs, which could, and already kind of do, stand as new rivals to NASA, alongside private firms like SpaceX and Virgin Galactic. As we're leaving history and going off into future realms here, it can't be certain, but all these relative newcomers to the space industry might just want to plant their own flags on the moon. So I guess we'll just have to wait and see what happens next. By the way, this video was made in collaboration with a bunch of other awesome EduTubers in celebration of the Apollo 11 lunar landing. As some of you may know, I've been a lifelong fan of space exploration, so naturally I could not say no to this collab. In fact, I might start doing more videos on space just to feed my addiction. Let me know what you think about that. In the meantime, if you want to see more videos about space right now, might I redirect you to the playlist that I have linked right here. If you enjoyed this crap, you will absolutely enjoy all the other videos here. Be sure to check out those videos if you haven't already, and subscribe to KhAnubis to learn something new every Sunday.